Please write it down. These are weak field ligands, and right hand side you get strong field ligands. Usually, as a thumb rule, these are all halides, right? Yes or no? तो जो हलाइड डोनर्स रहते हैं, दे आर क्लासिफाइड एज वीक फील्ड लिगेंड्स, ठीक है ना? देन ऑक्सीजन डोनर्स, ये भी वीक फील्ड के ही उसमें आते हैं. नाइट्रोजन एंड कार्बन के जो डोनर्स होते हैं, they are strong field ligands. So this is just as a thumb rule how to memorize or yaad kaise rakhne ka. So carbon and nitrogen donors, as you can see here, CO, carbon monoxide, or CN minus, or NO2, these are classified as strong field ligands, whereas the halides, they are classified as weak field ligands. बाकी बीच वाले भी वीक ही है, मतलब बेसिकली ये तीन जो रहते हैं ना, दे आर स्ट्रॉन्ग.
इनमें से ऐसा कोई तो होगा ना जो स्ट्रॉन्गर वीक में से मिडल में, उसके रिस्पेक्ट में हम कंपेयर कर रहे हैं, तो वो कौन सा?
किसके रिस्पेक्ट में? ऑक्सीजन वाले है ना बीच में,
H2O बोल सकते
हैं, H2O वीक फील्ड लिगेंड, मतलब स्प्लिटिंग उतनी स्ट्रांग नहीं होती है. वो नाइट्रोजन बोल तो रहा हूँ, यहाँ पे स्प्लिटिंग यहाँ पे डोमिनेंट होती है नाइट्रोजन एंड कार्बन की. जब तुम्हें गैप दिखना स्टार्ट हो जाएगा, जब इलेक्ट्रॉन मूव करना बंद कर देंगे, नोट कर लिया. अब जरा तुम खुद से मुझे बताओ इनका इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन कैसा रहना चाहिए. Fe H2O 6 2+ then Fe, this is CN, cyanide, 6 4-. Tell me the hybridization and then the geometry based upon whatever we have studied so far. Give me an answer. What do you think should happen? 2 minutes. sp3 d2. आया सबका? कैसे इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन बताओ इसका क्या होगा? 1s2 2s2 3p6 3s2 3p6 3d6. ये किसका बता रहा हूँ? Fe2+ का ना, बिकॉज 4s2 का द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विल मूव आउट, सो इट्स 4s0. ओके, so in d orbital 1 2 3 4 5, so there won't be any splitting in d orbital as such. There won't be any splitting in d orbitals. All of them will be degenerate because H2O is classified as weak field ligand. So 1 2 3 4 5 and then 6. 6 ligands aane, kitne ligands aane? 6. So this is 4s, then p, then d, 5d orbitals. एक लोन पेयर यहां पे आएगा, 1 2 3 4 5 एंड देन 6. सो व्हाट विल बी द हाइब्रिडाइजेशन? sp3 d2. ज्योमेट्री ठीक है, मतलब octahedral, square bipyramidal. Low spin or high spin? कल बताया था towards the end. High spin. Why high spin? 4 unpaired electrons. Inner orbital or outer orbital complex? Outer orbital complex. Why? Because 4d orbital is being used. Got it? Yes or no? समझ में आ रहा नहीं आ रहा? In case of CN, this is a strong field ligand. So what it will do? CN minus. It will split the D into two parts, EG and T2G. It will split the orbital in two parts, EG and T2G. So electronic configuration, it will be the same. So 3D, 6D distribution would be something like this. This is 3D, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, and then the pairing starts because these three are T2G orbitals. Which orbitals? T2G. And the remaining two orbitals will remain vacant. Means these two will remain vacant. So now what will happen? The 6 CN minus. These 6 ligands, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. CN, CN, CN. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yes. So, here in this the hybridization would be? D2, SP. समझ में आ रहा है? Is this clear to everyone? And the geometry would be the same, right? But the only thing is that hybridization would be different. So due to this, it will be low spin complex because there is no unpaired electron. Point number one. Point number two. Inner orbital complex. Why inner orbital? Because inner 3D is. I got example there. Solve it and then tell me. NiCN 4 2 minus and then solve it and then tell me the geometry. NiCl 4 2 minus. Geometry, the hybridization, everything, structure about these two, based on whatever we have studied so far. So let's start out with the geometry of NiCl 4 2 minus. Iska aaya kya nahi aaya? Iska aaya na? So let's start out with the geometry of this. निकल का इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन के दिन बेसिकली एनआई टू प्लस राइट वन एस टू टू एस टू टू पी सिक्स थ्री एस टू थ्री पी सिक्स थ्री डी सो और टू एस जीरो रहेगा बिकॉज टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हैव बीन रिमूव सो थ्री एट वुड बी वन टू थ्री 4, 5, 6, 7 and then 8. This is 4s and then 4p. How many ligands we have here? 4? So, ye 4s mein ek jaake baithega, 4p mein 3 jaake baithenge. So these three orbitals will combine together to give sp3 hybrid orbital and we know the geometry of sp3 hybrid orbital. What it will be? It will be tetrahedral. Okay, and it's going to be tetrahedral. So tetrahedral geometry we know. Now the twist in the story is in this case. Now which type of ligand is this CN? Strong. Very strong almost. Towards the end aata hai na? almost towards the end. Now let's try to understand what exactly happens in case of NiCN4 two minus. Try to understand it. The 3D, the regular configuration would be like this only. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5. 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Now what is going to happen is if we consider the octahedral complex that we had, these two orbitals are, one of them is dx square minus y square, another one is dz square, right? Jo upar wale yahan pe hai jinki energy high hai. Because the ligands are coming along the axis, along the x and along the y, positive x, positive y, negative x, negative, and also positive z and then negative z.